Salutations, spooks, spirits, and specters, and welcome back to more Clannad on the Tsunahara Mei route. As the two of us, Tomoya and Mei, are on the lookout for Yoshino Yusuke. Because after all, Yoshino is currently an electrical worker. We walk downtown side by side. I don't know how many times it's been that Mei-chan has shrieked in excitement like this. So that old guy looks like Yoshino Yusuke to you? You're way too invested in this, Mei-chan. Let's just say that if you do meet him, it'll be a nice surprise.
そうします. ごめんなさい.
You realize it says propane gas on the side, right? Her eyes are probably attracted to just about anything having to do with construction work. So that's how much she likes him, huh? Well, that's all the more reason to want to get a look at him. But we don't know where he is, so there's really nothing I can do. Since it's pretty unlikely we'll just randomly bump into him or something. This is gonna be difficult.
Okazaki-san! Are?
Mei-chan pulls on my sleeve several times. Her fingertip is trembling slightly. I look in the direction she's pointing. There he is! Right next to the light pickup truck, there's a young man taking off his white helmet. The man wiping off his sweat with a towel is, without a doubt, Yusuke Yoshino. It's the exact person we've been looking for.
お前、確か岡崎だったか?
Sup? He takes off his gloves, shoves them in his pocket, and comes up to us. Mei-chan is visibly flustered. What a coincidence.
ちょっとチェックする必要が出てきたな。
He fans himself using the clipboard he holds in his hand. It's holding what looks like a checklist of parts, but I have no idea what they are.
そっちの子は?
He takes a fleeting glimpse at Mei-chan, and she starts trembling.
かわいい彼女じゃないか。
He says half-jokingly, not noticing.
ありがとうございます。
This is bad, though. She's been wanting to meet him. But now that we're face-to-face with him, she has no idea what to say to him. Not to mention, Mei-chan is so nervous, she's not in a state where she could have any kind of a normal conversation.
元気そうで何よりだ。 じゃあな。
He gives me a reaffirming pat on the shoulder and turns on his heel. He then tries to go back to his truck.
あ, の?
Mei-chan reflexively holds out her hand, trying to keep him here. She drops the plastic bag that she had in her hand onto the ground. In it is the CD we'd bought just before. It tumbles when it hits the ground, making a sound. Let's see if I can replicate that. Come here, you. Come here. Come here. Yes, come here. There we go. And now... And then the contents fall out, sliding over the asphalt.
Oy, oy.
He gives a wry smile, crouches down, and holds out his hand. Ah, no, it's fine. I hurriedly try picking it up before he can, but I'm just one step too late. He easily picks up the CD.
気をつけろよ.
He wipes the case several times, trying to get the dirt off. And then his hand stops. His eyes fix on the album cover. Looks like the cat's out of the bag.
お前...
その...
She looks down and starts trembling slightly. I can feel her fingers naturally holding onto my sleeve. For a while, she avoids his gaze, and then...
ごめんなさい!
She suddenly apologizes.
私、知ってました。 あの... 岡崎さんから会ったって聞いてですね?
そうなのか?
Yeah. So I brought her along.
違います! 私が無理にお願いしまして! 本当は...
At Mei-chan's words, Yusuke Yoshino is speechless. After a short while, she raises her head. He impassively holds out the CD to her gently.
悪いな. ここに映っている男は俺じゃない. だから, そんな風に言われても困る.
It's obvious that this is a lie. But I'm sure he doesn't want to think back on those days. That much I can understand from seeing his blank expression.
ごめんなさい.
With her trembling hand, she takes the CD. She mutters this tiny apology as she bites her lip.
じゃあな.
He quickly turns his back on her and starts to walk away. Before long, his hand is on the door of the truck and he tries to get in.
あの...
At that moment, Mei-chan raises her voice.
私、ずっとファンでした。 すごく、吉野さんの歌が好きでした。 今も大好きです。毎日、いや、今は毎日ではないですけど。でも、週に一回は必ず聞いていると思います。落ち込んだ時とか、悲しくなった時とかは絶対に聞いてます。
Sorry for that. Apologies.
Yoshino さんの歌を聴くと強くなれる気がします。だから、その、
She probably doesn't even know what she's saying herself at this point. But despite that, she raised her voice.
元気な姿を見れて、嬉しかったです。頑張ってください。
She flings the words out to him. He receives them, hand still on the door. I almost thought he was going to ignore her and just leave. However, he doesn't. He closes the light pickup truck's door with force.
Yoshino-san.
And he walks up to us once more.Right up to Mei-chan. His eyes seem to be filled with some sort of tenderness as he looks at her.
だが、最後の言葉は一人の人間として受け取っておく。ありがとう。頑張るよ。
They were cheesy words, but when this person says them, they almost sound good. He softly puts his hand on Mei-chan's head.
名前は?
メイです。
そうか。メイ、頑張れよ。君がいつまでも前を向いて力強く歩いていけるよう。どんな逆境でも耐え抜いてまっすぐ歩いていけるよう。この俺も祈ってる。
I'm sorry, just seeing him put his hand in front of his face like that.
じゃあ、またな。
He murmurs just that and leaves. Mei-chan stares vacantly at his back as he walks off. On his way, Yusuke Yoshino gives me a glance and smiles.
岡崎。いい彼女だな。
Looks like he's joking again. And after a while, I hear the sounds of the engine firing.
はい。
One beat too late, Mei-chan cries out. And with that, I shall end it here.So thank you all very much for watching, and ciao for now. Ciao for now.